Right guys, in this video I'm using the XDJ RX2, making this video for two reasons. One is to look at the menu utility function, and also in a video I've done recently, I can't remember exactly when it will be online, but I was using a Karmic Power Records track and I was mixing using the low, mid and high, just showing you EQ. In that video, I did say that the RX2, when you use the RX2 by itself without an external player, you can only reduce the bass, mid or high by 26 dB. Well, that was incorrect, because if you go into utilities, you can set it to either do complete kill or minus 26 dB. So in a way, this video is covering two areas. One is looking at some of the features in menu utility and also showing you how you can select from minus 26 dB on low, mid or high, or complete kill. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to press down on the menu utility button, and now we get to the utility screen. So this is almost letting you decide how you want the player to work. Now something here, we've got quantized beat value. So quantize, let me talk a little bit generally about quantize. Now when quantize is engaged, let's imagine you're not brilliant at forming a loop, and maybe you press the in button slightly before the beat and the out button slightly after. Well, of course that loop is going to be out of time. Using quantize, it will snap it in time for you. Now the hot cue color, again, this is really mainly to do with the likes of Record Box. If we go, for example, to, let's have a look, on air display, pretty obvious. Vinyl speed adjust, we're on touch there. Autoplay mode is off. Now, ideally, you want that, because if you have autoplay mode on, it means that as soon as one track's finished, the next track will start, and it's a nightmare because, you know, you're trying to select a track and all of a sudden it starts automatically. So it's always a good idea to have autoplay mode off. What that means is that when you find a track and you queue it up, it's ready and it will start when you want it to start, not start by itself. Equalizer curve, we're on isolator. Now this is the key here, okay, this is what we're on about. So I'm on equalizer curve. If I press down, now the isolator is highlighted and I can turn the dial to equalizer. Now what that means is that now I will be able to use low, mid or high and increase or decrease, increase by plus 6%, decrease by minus 6. Press on that again and turn and go to isolator. Now what that means now is that when I turn the low, mid or high to the 7 o'clock position, it will completely cut that EQ, so you won't hear any of the sound. So if I just press play, there we go, it's completely gone. All I've done is I have turned the low, mid or high, listen to the bass, mid and high. There it is. So if I just turn the low, in fact, what I'll do, I'll put the EQ now to the center position. So you can see now full view, and click on there again, and let's move that to equalizer. And now, there. We can now hear a little bit of the volume. All right, so that's relatively important if you're the sort of DJ who wants to have complete kill on low, mid or high. Channel fader curve, that's not so important, but generally what you find a good setting is a natural increase in volume instead of like a slow increase then a sharp increase in the volume. Master attenuator, we've got that to 0 dB. So what that is that, you know, the output is 0 dB, exactly the same with the booth monitor. The only time it's a good idea to turn those up, if, let's say, for example, the speakers you're using, or, you know, the PA system needs a little bit more of a push out. So in other words, you've got to like maybe have the volume of your player giving more sort of push of an output, but I would highly recommend you keep it at 0 dB. A good way of explaining that is your LEDs. There's a reason for it being 0 dB. For example, you have amber, then you have green, and then you have red. As soon as you get to red, you're dead, and you do not really want to go over 0 dB. That's why it's set there in the beginning. So probably best just to leave it, unless, of course, you're a professional, you know what you're doing. Headphone mono split stereo, that's set to stereo, probably a good, maybe just leave it like that, okay? So at least when you plug in your headphones, you know you're going to get a stereo output. What else have we got? Mixer mode, MIDI control, language, again, you can choose your language. LCD brightness is the brightness of the screen itself. What else have we got on here? Screensaver is on. Always a good idea to have that on, because if you move away from the RX and you leave it there for a while, after a certain amount of time, it will just go dim and it will just save the screen. It'll, you know, give it a bit more life. Touch display calibration, auto standby is of course on, and your version. Now the version again is very important. What you need to do is maybe once a month or so, go to the Pioneer DJ website and go to firmware update and just have a look and see if there are any updates. If there are, check the version on the website. If it matches the one you've got on your player, you're good to go. If it's a number that's slightly higher, then check it out, because it might mean that you need to just change the firmware, update the firmware on the player. You know, sometimes there's a few bugs and it could be something very simple and it doesn't take long at all. Right, now I hope this has been a help. Again, we're using the XDJ RX2, but what I've shown you is very similar with a lot of just the basic CDJ players as well. All right, I hope that's been a help. Practice and enjoy. Thank you.